much. So, this week's edition of The Apprentice saw the candidates get in touch with their arty side. The teams were tasked with picking two urban artists before trying to sell their work to collectors.
It was all sorts of fun, but who failed to master the art of winning over Lord Sugar?
We'll be speaking to the losing candidate in just a moment. First, here's the moment when Sir Alan decided who to fire.
Tom, on this task alone, two massive, big flaws. The loss of pure evil and the choosing of James. Those decisions caused the fact that you didn't sell as much as the other people did. Jade, stretching beyond this task a little bit is my worrying concern about your indecisiveness in not pushing forward one of the other people from Bristol. That, I think, was another big error. But Tom, what with your existing business out there and my concern about you taking the space of someone else and these two errors,
I can assure you I'm
here.
Yeah,
I don't want to hear any more. Laura, you think you're a good salesperson. You're certainly a very good talker.
I am.
I'm not totally convinced that you should remain in the process. So, Laura, you're fired.
Take care.
Oh, Laura, even watching that, you're still sad, aren't you?
I know, but I was absolutely gutted. But what can I say? Here I am.
Well, tell us a bit more about that gutted, because we've seen a few of the people who've been fired have come through here, and they have different attitudes. Some are a bit pragmatic, and some act as if, you know, they're not that bothered. But it was pretty obvious from what we saw there, you really were gutted. You didn't see it coming?
I saw it coming a little bit, and I think you can tell in the final boardroom, you know, I can see it all over my face. I was obviously, when I saw the episode, I was watching it, and I knew I was in danger. I could see that. But yeah, I can't understand why you wouldn't be disappointed, to be honest with you. I mean, what a fantastic opportunity it was. And yeah, I was genuinely upset to be sent home.
And the thing that really seemed to upset you the most was that you kind of pride yourself on your selling skills, and that was what let you down, wasn't it?
Yeah, I was very disappointed in myself, and I think, I did say that in the boardroom. You know, I can't try and defend it. It was pretty poor performance on the night. But I was really, obviously, when you're in these situations, you're clawing at anything that will give you a chance at staying. And I was just trying to, you know, say, it's like everything, you know, everybody has a bad day, please. Yeah? No? Okay, then.
You can't have one there, though, can you?
That's it. You can't have one in The Apprentice. Unfortunately, I did. And, you know, it's hard in there. You know, a lot of things get on top of you, and, you know, you're just trying to keep plowing on sometimes, but if you just get a wee niggle and you take a wee dent to your confidence, you know, it's hard to get it back, you know?
I think we can see a little clip now. It was the selling process, and you're selling, this is street art.
Yes.
And you're selling it to anyone who basically wants to buy it, but it's quite a tricky sell in some ways. Let's have a look.
Which one do you want, Sita?
The bottom one.
The bottom one.
Starting to shift pictures, market trader Adam.
Yeah, I can do you that as a print, or I can do it in the frame.
On the print yourself, just print.
Yeah, do you want one of those? Yeah,
please.
Yeah. No problem.
One of the questions we was asked today was, which medium does he use? Now, a medium to me is someone who's used to contact the other side.
Great, good stuff. Well, if you need anything or if you think you want to go ahead with the purchase, I'll just be in the area. Just grab me again, OK?
Thank you.
No bother, I'll let you have a wee think about it.
Trying the soft sell, bridal shop owner Laura.
How are you doing?
Yeah,
good. Enjoying it?
Yeah, it's all right, yeah.
Good stuff. Had you heard of that?
It's not usually how I work. It's very different sales.
How are you getting on? Are you, like, enjoying it, yeah?
Yes, yeah. Thank you.
Good stuff.
It's all a little agonising there, isn't it? Looking back on it, the contrast between Adam's hard-selling technique and he's doing deals as he's talking to people, and you step back a bit, didn't you? Say, "Are you okay? Do you think now you should have had a different approach?"
Yeah, I should have been in I should have worked smarter, definitely. Yeah. I just don't think I really knew what was going to happen that night, in the sense of, we talked about this when you were fired as well, it was a feeding frenzy. As soon as the art collectors walked in the door, there was key pieces and they were gone.
Were they?
Half the sales were done, you know, pretty much in the first 20 minutes to half an hour. Mm. So I didn't get off to a particularly good start. And yeah, as I said, from then on, it was just a sort of... I just went downhill, really,
It's interesting, isn't it? Because you watched Tom, who was in charge of your team, and, yeah. you know, he agreed that he made a really big error in choosing the wrong artist, didn't he, actually? So, you know, it could have gone his way too, couldn't it? But by admitting it, did he play a better hand, do you think?
Possibly, but then I did also put my hands up and say, yeah, I agree, I wasn't a fantastic salesperson on the night, but Lord Sugar does, he likes people that take risks.
Yes, and right, which Tom definitely did, didn't he?
Yeah, and as I said, he did... you know, have a fantastic strategy and actually agreeing with that. And, you know, he put his hands up as well, and Lord Sugar respects that. But yeah, should I have gone? I mean, I still think, you know, I was a little bit of a scapegoat for it, to be honest with you, because ultimately, you know, all of us could have sold £100 more, but it was like, Laura, you should have done it. And, you know, why we lost the task was we did not have...
You didn't have the right artist,
we didn't have the artist that we wanted, you know, and really, it's hindsight, you know, who knows if we would have won if we'd had him or not, but we'd have had a, you know,
fighting chance.
People are often very diplomatic about the other rival contestants when they come in here. Did anyone rub you up the wrong way? Anyone who just... is anyone... You know, because naturally in life, there are people with whom you have a rapport and others who don't. Was it... Anything you want to tell us?
No, honestly, there was absolutely nothing.
You all got on perfectly.
Well, I wouldn't say we got on perfectly, but to be honest with you, I wasn't really interested in anybody else particularly. I was just in there purely focused on myself, and I just trying to keep myself to myself.
So, do you see sort of stags, you know, male or female? Do you see the characters who are
who form? Well, I think it's quite clear in this series. You know, you've got your guys full of bravado, alpha males trying to get the limelight, but. As I said, when you're in there, you're not really bothering about what anyone else is doing to a certain extent. Obviously, working in a team, you need to, but you know they can go and see what they want, get their airtime, do what they need to do, but I'm focusing on myself.
And who do you tip, because we've kind of, at this point, we can really see the characters emerging. Who do you tip for being in the finals, at least you think?
Well, this is the thing about The Apprentice, really, when you get to this stage, there is an element of luck in this. You know, any one of them could be in the final now, because there's a few people that have... Well, they've got off, I don't mean quite lucky, but that's the nature of this process. If you're in the winning team, you know, you can go in the winning team for a few weeks, you can still maybe not have performed that well, but you get through. So to be honest with you, it could be absolutely anybody. I should probably say Tom, since he put me out, then I'll have gone out to the winner. But I would like, for the girls, I'd probably like Gabby to do it for the girls.
Laura, what's the day job?
What's the day job? I'm a bridal shop owner. I own a boutique, Laura Rees Bridal, in Glasgow, which I'm about to move firmly forward with.
Well, good luck.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Good luck.
But I'm going to be starting a new venture soon, so I would probably say to anybody that's half interested in what I'm doing to go to my website, which is www.laurareesbridal.com.
You see, she says
she's not... .co.uk, sorry, got that wrong.
All the apprentices, they do that. Smart work, you see.
It's a good plug.
Gotta get the opportunity.
Definitely, gotta get the plug in, because as I said, it was a chapter of my life, but I'm very much moving forward with a lot of new exciting projects.
Good luck, Laura.
Yes, thank you very much. Thank you very much.
The Apprentice, of course, continues next Wednesday at 9 p.m. on BBC One. You can catch up with the episodes as well on the BBC iPlayer.
Just coming up to 8:45.